Welcome to the CBS Eye on Money podcast. It is Thursday, September 23rd, and it's coming towards the end of the week, and we are very happy that you've joined us. Mark, how's your construction project?
The wall is wide open in my bathroom.
Oof.
At least they covered it up, so no, you know, none of the roaches can come crawling in.
Or rats.
That would freak me. I can deal with a roach every now and again. A rat would freak me the hell out.
I see rats every night. I go out into the park. I take the girls out for a walk, and my dogs are called ratchers, meaning that they love to find rats, and they love to chase, and they find them. And I used to get so freaked out by it, and I don't anymore, which is good. It's good not to get freaked out by it, but it's amazing that I have literally have like almost like a non-response to it at this point.
Yeah, I was walking down the street on Saturday night. It was probably like 7:30, so it was already dark now this time of year. And a quiet street, and there's this big bush next to me. All of a sudden, I heard all this rustling in the bush. And, you know, obviously, there's a bunch of rats, but I didn't even think twice. Just kept going.
Oh, my God. That is hysterical. Anyway, let's get on to our caller and stop talking about rats. No one's going to come to New York now. Please come to New York. Okay. We have a listener joining us. It is Seth, who's on the line from Cleveland. So, Seth, what's going on? How can we help you?
So I have a question I've been toggling with for about the last 6 months. I'm hoping to get your insight here, Joe. So a little bit about me. I'm 32, engaged to be married next year. No kids plans at the moment. I make about $125K per year. I'm saving in a Roth 401k about 18%, 10% from myself, and about 8% from my employer. I've got 9 months of expenses in a liquid savings account. And then on top of the retirement savings, I'm able to save between $1,500 to $2,000 per year.
Per year or per month?
Per month. Per year would not be good.
Well, it'll be better than zero, but yeah. I would rather it be per month. So in the Roth, you're putting 10% in and then they match 8%?
Yeah. So they're matching 3%. And then one time each year, they're putting in an additional 5% of my previous year's earnings. So
wow.
The company, they're giving me that nice 8%.
Wow. But you could ostensibly put more than 10% in if you wanted to. I mean,
you're 100% right.
Right. Yeah. You could go up to 19.5, but you're not doing that now. Okay. I just wanted to make sure I understood that correctly. Okay. And you have 1500 to 2000 bucks a month. What is your engaged to be? What does this person do for a living?
Yeah. So she's a teacher. She makes about 70K per year. And she also has, you know, the Ohio pension plan for teachers.
Okay. And does she also have a 403B?
She does. Yep. And I believe it's 14% automatically.
That must be the pension, the 14%.
Yeah. Yep.
Okay. And how about any debt for either of you?
Nothing but the mortgage for both of us.
All right. The house is worth how much?
House is worth about 325.
How much mortgage is outstanding on this balance?
Yeah, about 215. So put a nice chunk down.
You did. And what about the interest rate?
Really low. It's only 3.3%.
3.3%. And it's 30 years?
Correct.
Okay, got it. So no student loans, no nothing. You like this house. You're going to stay in here for a while. This is all sounding pretty darn good. Is there anything that's nagging at you besides the $1,500 to $2,000 a month? Is there anything else that's outstanding that's on your mind financially?
Nothing nagging. And I guess kind of the purpose and the insight I was hoping to get from you was, you know, this extra money, you know, I hate debt, right? That's why I tried to wipe out the student loans as fast as I could. Any car debt, try to wipe out. And that's what's nagging at me is this extra $1,500 to $2,000 per month. I know mathematically it makes sense to probably invest that, get higher returnings. Mm-hmm. However, it helps me sleep a little bit better knowing I'm paying off debt and saving some of that interest. So
you've got to stop. Just stop. I mean, it is a tiny bit of a mortgage. You are saving lots of money. Paying this mortgage down is essentially like I get that you want this emotional relief, but you are thinking about this in, I think, in a too simplistic of a way. that, like, yes, you will get relief, but can I give you relief in another way, which is, won't it be great for you to have lots of money saved that's accessible to you? I'm not saying you're going to have this mortgage for 30 years. I don't think you will. But for the next 10, 15 years, use this to your advantage. You get a mortgage interest deduction. You have this working for you. This 3.3, it's not even a 3.3% note. It's really after you get your tax deduction, because I'm sure that you are now going to be an itemizer, that you can actually deduct this, and maybe it's costing you 2.7%. I got to believe that you can earn more than 4% or so on, or 5% on your long-term investments. And so why would you be paying down this note? It's like this weird emotional relief that really doesn't actually help you. Yeah. Have I guilted you into it or not?
I think you're getting me there. That's for sure. I need the tough love, because I know mathematically it's a no-brainer, and it's just something in my head that says, get rid of debt. You hate debt. Get rid of it. So
wait a second. Were your parents some sort of screw-ups? Why are you so anti-debt? What happened?
Definitely didn't have a lot of money growing up. And so maybe some of that plays into it, that, you know, we didn't have a lot of funds to go do stuff, or definitely wasn't a lot of investment talk around the house. And so I just kind of stumbled probably upon some very conservative type of literature early on, and it's kind of stuck with me.
You know what's interesting, though, about that? I think of it the other way. Like, you think you're going to get relief from paying this off. And you think, well, you know, I grew up with a little bit of scarcity mindset, right? Like, I didn't have a lot of stuff. Now, I think of it as, oh, great, you pay your house down, but then you don't have the money. You have a house and you can't go do stuff. And so if you actually want more flexibility, you want to save that money and not use it to pay down debt. Here's what I think I want you to do. Number one, the Roth 401k, right? I want you to max it out. Just max it out. So you've got $1,500 to $2,000 a month that's left over, right? Take $600 of that, or whatever it is, $550 a month, and max out your Roth 401k. I want you at $19,500. That's just a really smart way to do things right now, okay? So that's number one. Now, the wife-to-be, she, I think, is using the pension plan, but I don't know if she's using a 403b. I don't know if she's using a retirement plan. If she wants to use a deferred compensation plan, she can use that through work. Otherwise, that other extra money that you have, the $1,500 to $2,000 a month, you know, if you're really a wimp, and it sounds like you are, and I like that about people, you want to have a little more comfort instead of paying down the mortgage, well, you know, get up to 12 months of an emergency reserve fund. Let's do that first. And bump up your Roth 401k, and then you're probably going to have, like, I don't know, $1,000 a month. Mark, what do you want to do with $1,000 a month that they have extra? How are we going to burn it up?
I would open a brokerage account.
That's what I was thinking. I'm thinking a brokerage account also, because I think it will be good for you to know that you have some money that's been taxed that you can just start building. How are you doing with your investments? Do you feel comfortable investing on your own?
I should have probably mentioned that I do have about 15 in an individual brokerage account right now. So I've done a little bit, not a ton.
Fantastic. How have you invested? Tell me a little bit about that.
Yeah, balanced primarily in ETFs and just a couple of small stocks just to have a little bit of fun. But primarily I'm in a few different balanced ETFs.
So basically, you want to have fun investing in nonsense, and yet you also want to pay down your debt. No. Okay, so I'm going to give you both. I'm going to let you have your brokerage account. The $1,000 a month goes in there extra. So here's what we're doing to make that money go away fast. We're going to make sure that you have, instead of 9 months of emergency reserve, be 12 months. Then you're going to bounce up the 401k, the Roth 401k. You're going to be at $19,500, the limit. That's number two. Number three, excess beyond that goes into the brokerage account. Whatever's in that brokerage account, okay, that you put in there, I think you can do, let's call it 5 to 10, let's say 10%, go and play with 10% of that money. The rest of it, boring. Exchange traded funds or index funds, keep it easy breezy, not too aggressive, so it's there for you. Won't it be fun for you to see how much money you make with that brokerage account when you could be earning a whopping 3.3% by paying down your mortgage versus what you're going to make in the next 10 or 15 years in that brokerage account? You're going to kill it. You're going to make, it's going to be fantastic. So how do you feel about that as your game plan?
I love it. I love the idea of investing. So instead of paying off interest, we're going to make 4X that and invest in the brokerage account.
I didn't say 4X, mister. I said maybe 2.5X. So calm down. Let me ask you another question. Who's paying for the wedding?
We are. So luckily we've got a nice fund for the wedding set aside.
How much does it cost to have a wedding in Ohio?
It's going to be about 35.
Do you feel like you're spending a dopey amount of money, Seth? Or do you feel like, did you get obviously don't share this with your intended, but like, was this your like, oh my God, I can't believe I have to do this? Or are you feeling psyched about it?
Yeah, feeling psyched. I feel like still young, but obviously not like the 22, 23. So we were able to sock away the money. Mm-hmm. We have a really cool venue over the water. So looking forward to celebrating. So yeah, feeling comfortable.
All right. Well, that's good. How many people?
About 125.
Wow.
It's a lot. I don't even know that many people.
You do, but you just don't like them.
the only thing I was going to say about this house, Seth, is, you know, you're young, you're 32. I know you think this is going to be your forever house. And I thought that about the place where I live right now, but 4 or 5 years later, I know for sure we're moving. So just keep that in mind. Things could change. So you don't want to pay it down. And turns out you do stay there. You can always just pay this thing down later on.
That's a great piece of advice that, you know, you think I'm in the house I want to be in, but you know, who knows? Who does know? And this will give you flexibility and you'll have that big fat brokerage account. And, you know, wait until you get all the money from your wedding, pop it in the brokerage. Do people give, did you like register? I mean, that's the other thing. When you're 30 something years old, you already got stuff. So then you register and like, we're going to get more stuff. What are you doing?
That's exactly right. We already got the sheets and the nice silver china, whatever. Yeah. We just need money. Just please bring money.
did you register somewhere anyway? Because you know what sucks as someone who's been married and divorced twice, when someone is like, oh, I was going to go to your registry, but I wanted to give you this other thing. And you're like, well, why did I register if I wanted you to go to Bloomingdale's and pick something out that I don't like, you know, that's really the issue. Did you register or not?
No, nope, not at all.
Oh, I love it. Yep, so you're going for the cash.
Call it honeymoon fund, right?
I like that. Mark, I'll be Venmoing you your wedding present. I'm just going to go the regular system. All right. Seth from Cleveland, Ohio, send us pictures after you get married, all right?
Will do, Jill.
All right. Thank you so much for joining us. And it's great. I feel very comfortable that you are going to be happy with this decision. So I'm glad we could convert you away from the pay down mortgage camp into the invest the money and watch that money grow. So good luck to you.
Thanks so much for the help. I appreciate it.
Okay. If you have a question that is investment versus mortgage payoff or anything of the like, you have got to get in touch with us. It's so easy to do. All you need to do, hop onto our website, jillonmoney.com. Bookmark that website so that anytime you have a financial question, you go back there, boom, there's the contact button. Send us your question. So thank you so much. Don't forget, follow us on Apple or anywhere else you get podcasts. Subscribe to our sister broadcast. It's called Jill on Money. Do something nice for someone else today. Remember, curiosity, compassion, community. That's what we're about here. So let's all embrace it. Thanks for listening. We'll talk to you next week.